Welcome to Ezra's channel. My name is Fitria. I am a student of English Study Program Semester 5. Introduction of Semantics. Semantics is the study of the meaning of words and sentences as its symbols. Concerned with the relation of linguistic form to non-linguistic concept and mental representation in order to explain how sentences are understood by the speakers of language. Semantics is the study of meaning in language. We know that language is used to express meanings which can be understood by others. But meanings exist in our minds, and we can express what is in our minds through the spoken and write forms of language. The sound features of language are studied at the level of phonology, and the organization of words and sentences is studied at the level of morphology and syntax. Next, brief history of semantics. Generally speaking, semantics is the study of language and its meaning. As a word, semantics was first used by Michel Brill, a French philologist, and can be used to describe how words can have different meanings for different people. A language can be a natural language, such as French, Dutch, or Hindi, or it can be an artificial language, such as a programming language for computers. Technology, computer scientists study and develop artificial language, while linguistics study natural language. In the last two decades, the dream of adding natural language to computers and having them speak as casually as humans has developed significantly. Next, scope of semantics. 1. Naming. Naming deals with the possibility of treating language as name coincer. 2. Concept. According to Ferdinand de Saussure, the linguistic sign consists of a signifier of a significant sounds, image, concept, and self are called significant. Next, tense and preference. The term preference means the relationship between linguistic form and the outside world. Next, word and lexeme. The word is not a clearly defined linguistic unit. The last, sentence. The traditional definition of a sentence is the expression of complex thought. As we communicate with sentence, not words, we can also call sentence as the basic unit of meaning. Reach to the study semantics. There are two approaches to the study of meaning in language. 1. The contextual approach to meaning views meaning in language in terms of context, citation, or use. This approach necessitates the existence of an external stimulus that triggers the human brain to produce a meaning as a response to the stimulus. The structuralist Blumfield states the meaning of a linguistic form is the situation in which the speaker utters it and the response which it calls for in the hearer. Next, the metalistic approach to meaning in language views meaning as concept, ideas, image, and association which are stored in the long-term memory of the human brain. Meaning is inside the brain. According to the Carroll, concept, ideas, image, and the association are derived from the mental representation of world reality. Carlos K. Ognen and Ivor Armstrong Richards in the fight to understanding comes from within the people rather than from the words they just interpret.